Welcome to another video on Keycloak Identity and Access Management System. In this video, I am talking about client scopes in Keycloak. As the prerequisites, you need to know about protocol mappers and role scope mappings in Keycloak. In the previous two videos, I have covered these two topics. If you are not familiar with these two concepts, please watch my previous videos. First, we need to understand the motivation for client scope. In order to add attributes to an OpenID Connect token or SAML assertion, we need to use protocol mappers and role scope mappings. If you have few client applications, you can configure protocol mappers and role scope mappings easily. But if there are many client applications, it is difficult to configure protocol mappers and role scope mappings in each client separately. Client scopes are used to resolve this issue. A scope contains a set of protocol mappers and role scope mappings. Also, scopes can be associated with any number of clients. Therefore, protocol mappers and role scope mappings can be defined in a single place and can be shared among multiple Keycloak clients. This is the idea about Keycloak client scopes. In order to learn about how to work with client scopes, let's visit to the admin console. On the left menu pane, you can see the client scopes menu item. I am visiting that page to create a new client scope. I create a new scope by clicking create button. I put the name as HexaScope. I keep the other form values unchanged. If you want to know more about them, you can hover over the question mark and see the description. I save this scope. Once scope is created, you can see it has two tabs to add protocol mappers and role scope mappings. I add one protocol mapper for demonstration purpose. I add a built-in protocol mapper. Add selected. Also, I add a single role scope mapping as well. I go to the scope tab. Here's a realm role named simple role. Click add selected. Now this particular client scope has a one protocol mapper and one role scope mapping. I go back to the scopes page. Here you can see another special tab named default client scopes. If I mark a client scope as default, it will be automatically added to newly created clients. All the available default scopes can be seen on the right side. I am going to talk about optional client scopes in a short while. Therefore, I skip that section. In order to add scopes to a client, I need to go to the clients page. I am using the Hexa client, which was created in a previous video. I select the client. I go to the client scope tab. Right now, here you can see I am in the setup tab. Also, you can see the newly created scope available on the left side. I add it to this client. You can see there is another section named optional client scopes. So this is the time to talk about optional client scopes. Optional client scopes are not implicitly added to the token. Therefore, they should be explicitly requested by the scope parameter in OpenID Connect authorization request. After that, they will be added to the token. Now we know how to assign a client scope to a particular client. As you already know, a client can have multiple client scopes. Each client scope can have a set of protocol mappers and client scope mappings. Therefore, a client inherits lots of protocol mappers and role scope mappings. In order to find all the protocol mappers and role scope mappings inherited by a client or perhaps configured within the client, I visit the Evaluate tab. If required, I can add optional client scopes also for the evaluation. Here I click the Evaluate button. Effective Protocol Mappers section shows all the protocol mappers inherited from scopes and configured within the client. Effective Role Scope Mapping shows all the inherited role scope mappings from scopes and configured within the client. We can evaluate a sample token by prodding a user here. I already have a user named Hexa in this realm. Once I click the Evaluate button, another tab appears as Generated Access Token. By visiting to that tab, we can inspect the generated access token by this client on behalf of the given user. So, this is what I wanted to explain in this video. See you in the next one. Thank you very much.